हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ आहेर डिया फ्रॉम RBNB कॉलेज श्रीरामपुर। टुडे आई डिलीवर ए लेक्चर ऑन रोटेशनल डायनेमिक्स फ्रॉम HSC बोर्ड सिलेबस। इन दिस सब टॉपिक इज मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया एज एनालॉगस क्वांटिटी फॉर मास। Before starting this article, everybody knows mass, and when we consider rotational motion, so for rotational motion we know that body is rotating about its own axis, and that's why such motion is called as rotational motion. So in case of rotational motion, body rotates about its own axis. For example, earth is rotating about its own axis. This is the one example of rotational motion. Now everybody is familiar with linear motion. Motion of a body along the straight line, it is called as linear motion. Now if we consider some physical quantities like force having formula mass into acceleration. Now in a rotational motion, there is torque acting on the body, and this torque is equal to I into alpha, where I is the moment of inertia, alpha is angular acceleration. As body rotating about its own axis, therefore alpha is its angular acceleration. Now if we consider this equation 1 and this equation 1, in rotational motion torque is equal to I into alpha. In linear motion, force is equal to mass into acceleration. This torque in the rotational motion is analogous with the force in the linear motion. As both these quantities are analogous to each other, therefore we can say that this I means moment of inertia of a body in rotational motion is analogous to the mass in the linear motion. Also, we know another formula for linear momentum is product of mass into velocity is called as linear momentum. This momentum is along the straight line, that's why it is linear momentum. In a rotational motion there is angular momentum, and this angular momentum is equal to I into omega. So this is equation 2. Also in that case, the momentum in a linear motion is analogous to the angular momentum in rotational motion. That's why moment of inertia in rotational motion again analogous to the mass in the linear motion. Similarly, if we consider kinetic energy of a body having formula half m v square, where v is the velocity of the body, m is the mass of the body. In linear motion, kinetic energy is equal to half m v square. Now if we consider in rotational motion, there is rotational kinetic energy, and this rotational kinetic energy is equal to half I omega square. So this is also equation 3. So in this way we study the analogy of moment of inertia with the mass. Now first of all we have to study what is moment of inertia. So if we consider a rigid body, We know the rigid body. What is rigid body? A body in which the distance between particle remains constant, even an external force acting on that. For example, stone. If we apply the force on the stone, it remains as it is. Therefore, it is called as a rigid body. So, if we consider rigid body rotating about its own axis. So, rigid body as like this one. This is the rigid body. And this rigid body rotating about an axis passing through the point O. This axis is perpendicular to the plane of the figure. This axis is perpendicular to the plane of the figure. And in that case, if this rigid body consists of n number of particles of masses, first particle having mass say m1, which is situated at distance say r1 from the axis of rotation. If we consider second particle of mass m2, situated at distance r2 from the axis of rotation. As like this one, last particle whose mass is mn, which is situated at rn from axis of rotation. Now from this figure, we have to find out moment of inertia. What is moment of inertia? If you consider this first particle of mass m1 situated from situated at distance r1 from the axis of rotation, then its moment of inertia of that particle is m r m1 r1 square. M1 r1 square for first particle. If we consider the second particle, addition of this one, m2 r2 square. This is the moment of inertia of this particle m2, whose mass is m2, which is situated at distance r2 from the axis of rotation. Now if we consider last particle plus, whose mass is mn rn square, which is situated at distance rn from the axis of rotation. And if this body is rotating about this axis in anti-clockwise sense, then its moment of inertia is I equal to m1 r1 square plus m2 r2 square plus mn rn square. This can be written as like this one, in the form of summation I tends to 1 to n mi ri square, where this I is called as moment of inertia. So if you consider this equation A, this equation 1 represents moment of inertia of a rotating body about its own axis, and which is given by I is equal to summation I tends to 1 to n mi ri square. Now with the help of this formula, we can define the definition of moment of inertia. So what is moment of inertia? This I is the moment of inertia, which is equal to sum of product of these two physical quantities, product of mass of each particle and square of its distance from the axis of rotation. That is called as moment of inertia. So with the help of this formula, we can define the definition of moment of inertia of a rotating body about its own axis. So we define the moment of inertia. The moment of inertia of a rotating body about its own axis is defined as sum of product of mass of each particle and square of its distance from the axis of rotation. So this is the moment of inertia. Now with the help of this formula, we can find out SI unit of moment of inertia. SI unit of moment of inertia is, in short, moment of inertia is written as MI, M dot I dot, means moment of inertia. Now mass, SI unit of mass is kilogram, and रेडियस मीन्स डिस्टेंस, सो डिस्टेंस इज मेजर्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ मीटर, सो स्क्वेयर ऑफ मीटर, सो वी गेट मीटर स्क्वेयर. सो सिंपली वी गेट SI यूनिट ऑफ मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया इज किलोग्राम मीटर स्क्वेयर. नाउ ऑल्सो वी ऑब्टेन द CGS यूनिट ऑफ मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया. CGS यूनिट ऑफ मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया इज मास इन CGS इज ग्राम एंड लेंथ इज इन सेंटीमीटर, सो ग्राम सेंटीमीटर स्क्वेयर. So with the help of this formula, we can write the SI unit and CGS unit of moment of inertia. Also with the help of this formula, we write the dimensions of moment of inertia. So what are the dimensions of moment of inertia? Dimensions of moment of inertia are, here mass is present. So m raised to plus 1. Length is also present, so length square L raised to plus 2, but T is absent, therefore we write T raised to 0. So these are the simple dimensions of moment of inertia. Dimensions of moment of inertia are M raised to plus 1, L raised to plus 2 and T raised to 0. So in this way, with the help of formula, we can write the definition of moment of inertia. Also, we write the SI unit, CGS unit and dimensions of the moment of inertia. So remember again, what is moment of inertia? Moment of inertia is defined as sum of product of mass of each particle and square of its distance from the axis of rotation. If we consider there is uniform distribution of mass. Uniform distribution of mass means this body consists of elements and each element having same mass. So for that we write for uniform distribution of mass means we take homogeneous body, homogeneous rigid body. Homogeneous rigid body means this rigid body consists of small elements and each having same mass, that is equal to dm. Then same formula is written, instead of summation we write integration. Integration of mass of each element is dm. So r square dm, integration of r square dm, this is also formula for moment of inertia for homogeneous body or for uniform distribution of mass. In that case, moment of inertia is equal to integration r square dm. So both formula, remember all these two formula of moment of inertia. Now we have to study the moment of inertia as analogous quantity for mass with the help of determining the rotational kinetic energy. For that purpose, we consider again same rigid body which is rotating about its own axis with constant angular velocity, say omega, in anticlockwise sense. Now for our reference, we write here I is equal to summation I tends to 1 to n mi ri square, here equation A. Now we consider a rigid body rotating about its own axis passing through the point O. This axis is perpendicular to the plane of the figure. As body rotating in anticlockwise sense with constant angular velocity, say omega, then this particle of mass m1 revolving around the axis of rotation in a circle, and there is circular motion, that circular motion is uniform circular motion. In that case, its angular velocity omega is constant for all particles. So body rotating about its own axis, motion of body is a rotational motion, but motion of particle is a circular motion, and that is UCM, because in that case this body revolving or moving along this circumference of a circle whose angular velocity or angular speed is constant, therefore it is UCM. So this rigid body consists of masses m1 comma m2 comma m3 dash mn which are situated at distances r1 comma r2 dash rn respectively from axis of rotation. When body rotating about its own axis, its particle of masses m1, m2, m3, dash, mn which are situated at distances r1, r2, dash, rn respectively from the axis of rotation perform uniform circular motion. All these particles perform uniform circular motion. Now in a circular motion, linear speed is given by, or linear velocity is given by r into omega. V is equal to r into omega, where V is the linear speed, omega is angular speed. Now if we consider first particle of mass m1, then its linear velocity is perpendicular to this r1. So this is the velocity of first particle. V1 is the velocity of first particle. This V1 and r1 both are perpendicular to each other. We studied in last lecture. Also, so we write, according to this relation, for first particle, this V1 is equal to, now this V1 is equal to, distance is R1 into omega. Omega is constant, so we write V1 is equal to R1 into omega for first particle. Now we consider second particle, again its velocity is perpendicular to R2, whose mass is M2. Now we write with the help of this, V2 is equal to R2 into omega. V2 is equal to R2 into omega. Now for last particle, whose mass is Mn, which is situated at distance Rn from the axis of rotation, its velocity is Vn, and Vn is equal to this Rn into omega. Rn into omega. So by using relation between linear motion and angular motion, we find out linear velocity for first particle, that is equal to V1 is equal to R1 omega. Similarly, for last particle, its velocity is Vn is equal to Rn into omega. Now we know the formula for kinetic energy. We have to find out kinetic energy of this particle. So formula for kinetic energy is half mv square. So write kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. Now if we consider first particle whose mass is m1 and whose velocity is v1, then its kinetic energy, say e1, is equal to half m1 v1 square. For first particle, its kinetic energy is half into m1 v1. Now we know that, what is the value of v1? v1 is equal to r1 into omega. So by substituting this, we get half into m1 into v1 square. If v1 is r1 omega, then v1 square is r1 square omega square. So we substitute this value. So we get half m1 into r1 square omega square. In this way, we get kinetic energy of first particle whose mass is m1 and its corresponding velocity is v1. Now, if we consider second particle whose mass is m2 and velocity is v2, then kinetic energy for second particle is e2. That is equal to half m2 v2 square. As we know that v2 is equal to r2 omega, so v2 square is equal to r2 omega square. Now in this case, remember that all particles revolving with different linear velocities, but all particles having same angular velocity, say omega. Now we get E2 is equal to value of V2 square is R2 square into omega square. Then substituting this value, we get half M2 R2 square omega square. Now in this way, for last particle whose mass is MVN and velocity is VN, then its kinetic energy is EN, that is equal to half MN VN square. So we substitute here value of VN square, that is equal to RN square omega square. When we substitute this value of Vn square, that is equal to Rn square omega square in this equation, then we get half Mn Rn square omega square. Now we have to find out total kinetic energy of a rigid body rotating about its own axis. And this total kinetic energy of rotating body about its own axis is the sum of kinetic energies of all particles. So, by using this one, we get total kinetic energy of rotating body, E rotational, that is equal to kinetic energy of first particle plus kinetic energy of second particle plus dash dash kinetic energy of last particle, En. Now we substitute values of E1. E1 is equal to half M1 R1 square omega square. Similarly, for second particle, kinetic energy is half M2 R2 square omega square plus dash dash kinetic energy of last particle, half mn rn square omega square. Now here we write total equation, last equation, kinetic energy of a rotating body. That is equal to E rotational equal to, by taking common here half and omega square, remaining is in bracket, so we write half omega square in bracket for first particle, remaining is M1 R1 square, for second particle M2 R2 square plus dash dash for last particle Mn Rn square, bracket completed. Now this bracket can be written in the form of summation. So we get summation of I tends to 1 to n, that is equal to Mi Ri square. In that case, this is equal to I, so instead of this bracket, we write directly E-rotational means total kinetic energy of a rotating body about its own axis is half as it is. Value of this bracket is I means moment of inertia and omega square as like this one. So this is the final equation. E rotational is equal to half I omega square, where I is the moment of inertia of a rotating body, omega is its angular velocity. So in this way we can say that if you consider kinetic energy in linear motion, this is equal to half mv square, and if we consider same kinetic energy in a rotational motion, that is equal to half I omega square, then this I is analogous to the mass. So this is the analogy between moment of inertia and mass. So everybody understood up to this one. Today we stop here.